Hi everybody, this is Angie from Tourangie.com, and today we're in Welch, and I'm sitting here trying to back out of this parking spot at the courthouse. You're going to see that video start shortly, but right now is just a bunch of pictures. I got out of the car and took pictures of this little tiny park that's right beside the courthouse, and of course there's a picture of the courthouse and some of the buildings there on the street, and just some little markers here in the park, talking to you, telling you a little bit about history and different things. So I thought I would share those pictures with you, and then this little video will start of me backing out of this little parking spot and driving through Welch. Right now I'll say that the part of Welch I'm driving through is consider the lower half. There's an upper and a lower. If you're from here, you'll understand. So I came into Welch on the lower, and that brings you through downtown, and we're going to finish going through downtown. But when I leave, I'm going to be going out the upper, and that's still Route 52. It's just one's more of a business and one's just the route. Anyway, I'm doing the loop, so you'll be able to see, you know, me going out on the upper part of 52. So, I hope I explained that well enough. Anyway, you'll get some views of this downtown area first off, and then it goes into little curves and mountainous road kind of, and then you're going to see houses, and then I'll be taking a left, and you'll be going up a hill with some curves, and there we go. We'll be coming back out at the bottom of Welch, where you can turn a left and go right back into the city where I'm just leaving from. So yeah, I hope you enjoy this video, and I'm going to read a little bit of information to you. I did a lot of Welch history on the last video, but this is a website called Blue Ridge Country. So go to blueridgecountry.com to learn more about different things. They've got a nice, they talk a lot about a lot of different things. Yeah, this little article talks a lot about history and tourism and different things, but I'm going to read you, it's a large article, but I'm going to read you some things. That's at the bottom. It says, Welch, did you know? It has the largest number of veterans per capita in America. The year 2021 will mark the 103rd annual Veterans Day Parade, which is another American record. Mentioned this before. Steve Harvey was born in Welch. That was on my last video. Author Jeanette Walls, The Glass Castle. She wrote The Glass Castle. She attended Welch High School. Welch Veterans Park is the home to the West Virginia boxcar from the French Gratitude Train sent by the French to thanks for the American assistance during World War II. And the last thing on this list, I'll mention it, but it's not technically Welch, even though they mention it in Welch. It's close by. Colwood is the home of Homer Hickam, NASA engineer, and author of memoir October Sky, the movie October Sky. But that's actually Colwood. That's not Welch. But they do mention Welch in the movie. of course, I've seen the movie. Anywho, that's just a little bit of information I thought I would share from that website, and I'm going to find a little bit of more for you. So we're going to talk about mining a little bit. There used to be so many mines in McDowell County. I'm not talking just Welch, I'm just talking McDowell County in general. I've mentioned those in the last video. Tons of old mines. Well, things have changed in this area. Obviously, the coal mining has not, you know, it has fallen down a lot since the 1950s. Population has died down here. In Welch, McDowell County in general, lots of mines have closed, this, that, and the other. But we're going to talk about the counties in West Virginia that they still mine coal. Now, they still mine coal in McDowell County, and at one point it was the number one producing county. But as of right now, it's Marshall County is number one, Logan County number two, Ohio County number three, Raleigh County number four, Marion County number five, Wetzel number six, Wyoming number seven, Taylor number eight, Kanawha number nine, Boone number 10, and number 11 is McDowell County. So that's kind of shocking to me. West Virginia is still the largest producing coal state in the United States, but there are 10 other counties that actually have higher production in coal than McDowell County. I did not know that, so I figured I would share that information with you. Now, I know that I just read that West Virginia was still the state that produced the most coal, but I just read something else that shocked me, and it says, which U.S. state produces more coal than West Virginia? And it says Wyoming. I did not realize that. It says that Wyoming, the two largest coal mines in the United States are in Wyoming. So I did not realize that. I thought that West Virginia was still ranked number one, but no, it is number two. It is Wyoming. Wyoming is 41% and West Virginia is down to 14%. So, there's some more information for you. And the last thing I'll tell you that I just found out is where does West Virginia export their coal to? The Netherlands, India, Brazil are some of the top countries that receive coal from West Virginia. Pretty cool. And oh, also, guess what state is the number one state for using coal in the United States? Texas. That's interesting. All right, well, that's enough information for today. I hope you've enjoyed this video of me driving through Welch and then the country roads and getting on Route 50. Well, it's all Route 52, business or not. And I'll be heading back to Bluefield on the next few videos. Talk to you later. Come to my website, tourangie.com, read my blogs, check out, make appointments, and so I can help you plan your next travel adventure, whether it's trips, gosh, all-inclusive resorts, cruises, trips, wherever, road trips. I can help you out. Talk to you later.